I can dedicate this to the righteous people.
Oh, this may be the beginning, or this could be the end. The watcher only knows. This is the memory of God. This is the countdown for the soul. This is Hawkwind.
To find that I'm so later, to find
chimneys polluting the air, its roots poisoning the earth, its tentacles setting one man against another and strangling them both in their hopeless contest. I would map the city's highways and tunnels and bridges, its subways and canals, its neighborhoods adorned by beautiful homes filled with priceless objects, rare libraries and fine rooms, its clever networks of pipes and cables and wires under the streets, its police departments and communication stations, its hospitals, churches and temples, its administrative buildings crowded with overworked computers, telephones, and servile clerks. Then I would wage war against this city as if it were a living body. I would welcome the night, sister of my skin, cousin of my shadow, and have her shelter me and help me in my battle. I would lift the steel into the gutters and drug exploded into the black tent. Then I would run away and hide, waiting for the thunder which would trap in new telephone wires, millions of unheard words which would darken rooms full of white light and fearful people. I would wait for the midnight storm which whips the streets and blurs all shapes, and I would hold my knife against the back of a doorman, yawning in his gold-frothed uniform, and force him to lead me upstairs, where I would clutch my knife into his body. I would visit the rich and the comfortable and the unaware, and their last screams would suffocate in their ornate curtains, all tapestries and priceless carpets, their dead bodies pinned down by broken statues, would be gazed upon by slashed family portraits. Then I would run to the highways and speedways that surge forward toward the city. I would have with me bags full of bent nails to empty on the asphalt. I would wait for the dawn to see cars, trucks, buses approaching at great speed and hear the bursting of their tires, the screech of their wheels, the thunder of those steel bodies suddenly growing weak as they crashed into each other like wine glasses pushed off a table. And in the morning I would go to sleep, smiling in the face of the day, the brother of my enemy!
Thank you.
in case of sonic attack on your district, follow these rules. If you are making love, it is imperative to bring all bodies to orgasm simultaneously. Do not waste time plucking your ears. Do not waste time seeking a soundproof shelter. Try to get as far away from the sonic source as possible. Use your wheels, it is what they are for. Do not attempt to use your own wheels. If no wheels are available, metal, not organic wheels, should be employed whenever practical. Remember, in the case of sonic attack, survival means every man for himself. Statistically, more people survive thinking only of themselves. Do not attempt to rescue friends, relatives, loved ones. You have only a few seconds left to escape. Use those seconds sensibly or you will inevitably die! Do not panic. Do not panic. Think only of yourself. Think only of yourself! On the first signs of sonic attack, you will notice small objects such as organs oscillating. You will hear a distant hissing in your ears. You will feel dizzy. You will have difficulty focusing. There will be an ink upon the region. You may be subject to hits of the small ocean. And remember, you can help no one else. You can help no one else.